So guys, just six here, Thursday 24th, made a bit of progress today. As you can see, we'll start off at the aft section. Here we've got the new rudder arm seal, which I'm not real happy with at the moment, but anyway, we'll get to that. Then moving forward, I had to make a new cover for the winch servo. The Vigor's slightly lower profile and a bit longer, so that hole there will be filled with silicone, so don't worry about that. It's made out of plastic and some 3-ply, which I've sanded down to basically be 2-ply, and I've sealed it with clear lacquer, a couple of coats, and that'll be screwed down. There's a deflector on the front because the water flow over the front might cause some problems. The two uprights you see there are actually threaded. I haven't cleaned the paint off them yet, but they'll be for mounting various apparatus, a la cameras, etc. There's a wooden block under that too. Further forward, we see the new Fairlead, and I'll put a dome around that to stop any sheet entanglements. So the line here is much better up to the boom, much better than before where it went down to the hull, the deck. Here we have under deck areas, rudder servo with my fancy red aluminium huge servo. This is a vertical bolt which will for the deck mount, for the hatch cover, sorry. And here is a peephole basically down to the bottom of the hull so I can see if there's any water. Progress a little with my battery pack mount. It's not much different. I've just added a surround to hold the container in place, which can be removed, of course, so we can see if there's any, well, if there's more water. And you'll see down below the deck there, down on the bottom of the hull, there's a timber beam that holds the battery section in place. I used to use a rubber O-ring, but basically I've made a little plate to seal it off. There you can see the AR7000 main receiver. Sorry about the giddy camera work. Oh, yellow. Okay. And there's the satellite receiver that connects to the AR7000, which mounted on a different axis so that it gives better range, or better reception, actually. What else have we got here? You can see around the hatch opening there, I've actually filed that away because it was not flat. And the hatch is flat and it wasn't sealing properly. So that'll have a soon to be released rubber, or I'm not sure if it's rubber, but it'll be attached to that, and I'll show you that in another video. So here you can see we can slip this waterproof, waterproof from the bottom holder in, and we can slide our battery pack, which I've wrapped in some clear tape and silicone, both top and bottom, just in case. And our wires just slide under the deck like so. So this is the waterproof switch, and yes, Vince, it is epoxied onto the deck. There's no thread on it. A little red indicator there means on. No fancy LEDs in this baby. Well, I don't need them anyway because the receivers have got LEDs in them which indicate power before I... once the deck hatch is on, I guess I can't see them, but whatever. So let's just turn this over a little bit. Sorry about the bad camera work. So there you can see the receiver. And it's actually a better shot now because you can see down to the bottom of the hull through that opening. So turn the power on, and the flashing light indicates that I forgot to turn my transmitter off after the last shutdown, which means basically it's lost signal at some point, so it flashes. But we can fix that. So now she's syncing up, and there's the solid red LED. There's also one in the satellite receiver, and you can see that the servo's centered and is operational. Let's give you a better look at that. You can see the solid LED there. Bit shaky on this stand. I've got to make a new stand. This thing sucks. But it actually allows me to put the fully rigged yacht inside without hitting the ceiling. So a few cosmetic changes, quite a bit of technical changes, I guess you could say. Coming along pretty well, I think. Let's show you the winch. This is the new Vigor, what is it, forgotten the model, YM22, I think, metal gear from Hobby King, courtesy of Admiral Tugboat. Thank you, sir. So we have operation, and we'll just give the winch a little bit of a spin. Bear in mind, I haven't reprogrammed my radio to allow for the travel length of this winch. It's still set at the old standard hurricane one. So here we go, we've got 2.75 turns, I think. That's from sheet it out to sheet it in. So 2.75 turns. But like I said, I've got endpoints set for the original winch, so I'll be adjusting those, reprogramming those tomorrow probably. What else have we got? I should give you a look at the profile angle, I guess, to show you the difference. Penguin, you'll appreciate the profile difference of the winch cover housing there. Don't worry about the spots, it's just fingerprints. So that's the new profile of the winch cover and the mainsail fairlead dome. I'm pretty sure that'll work. Can't see it getting caught up anywhere. You can see there on the side, the forward loop is for the mainsail sheet, and the aft one goes to the drum wheel. So all in all, quite a bit of work done today. Sorry it's taken so long to go through this, but there you go.